Right.
This is the G.I. Jive.
Cool beans.
It starts with the bugler blowing reveille over your bed when you arrive. Jack, that's the G.I. Jive. Rudely toot. Jump in your suit. Make a salute. After wash and dress, more or less, you go get your breakfast in a beautiful little cafe they call the mess. Jack, when you come for less, out of your seat, into the street. Chunk all your junk back in the trunk. Fall on your bunk. Club.
I'm gonna blow some shit up. Trying to stay awake. I'm gonna blow some shit up. I'm disabled. It's what we do. Prost. There you go. So that. Hey! Smutty. If you're there, check it out. Hey, check it out, man. This is show and tell just for you. Check it out, dude. The Wehrmacht helmet. The old Wehrmacht helmet. Oh, sorry. Let's kick ass. Do you see how cool I'm going to look with this helmet, with the Gandalf mask on, and I'm like flying downtown with a loudspeaker with war sound shooting out of both speakers on my wheelchair? It'd be badass. like a tank. Put smiley face right there, a sticker with the smiley face, and then put a sticker on that side with a big FU sticker on it. But anyway, dude, I pulled that out in case you hopped in. I thought you might want to see it. Hey man, if you're going to play your game, have fun, good gaming, good luck, kick some ass. In the Forgotten Hope, I tried to run it. In Forgotten Hope, unfortunately, when I run that windowed, it messes up my HUD. Like the menus are off. I can't click on anything. So I can't run the on-screen chat. And it sucks. I wish I could run the on-screen chat in this game, but I can't in this game. The Warband games, all the Warband games, I can use on-screen chat, no problem. But Forgotten Hope, I can't. But I'm just saying, you know, if you can't chat, dude, and you're going to cruise and play your games, man, you won't offend me at all. You won't offend me at all. See, that's the other thing, is I wish that there was a sound alert so that when you chat... When you chat to me, I should get a sound alert, like a beep, so I know that you're chatting to me. And I can't find a setting for that. Eventually, what's going to happen is I'm going to get Streamlabs set up so that I can have chat on my screen, or, like you suggested, I'll put it on a tablet or on my phone. And I think that, your suggestion is a good solution. I'm a fucking nutcase, man. Are you kidding me? Did you know I used to be Willy Wonka's gardener? I used to be the president's gardener, too. I used to take care of the Tomb of the Unknowns. And I had a level 6 security clearance as a gardener. I think I was the highest security clearance gardener in America. I manage the number one green industry corporation in the United States. SCP Foundation, I don't know what that is. What is the SCP Foundation? Is that music too loud? And now I have multiple sclerosis and I'm retired and I play video games. It's a fake place. Oh, right on. Cool. I saw earlier I was looking at games. I was watching you play, but before I was watching you play, I was looking at some other games. People playing that game called Black Wake. It's kind of like a cartoony pirate game, but it's cartoony. It's real fantasy. I like to fight, though, with swords on ships, you know? You know, I played the Warband, the Caribbean Warband. I have that, where it's Warband, but it's in the Caribbean. And it's so, I don't like it. I played it for like a whole day a couple of years ago, and I just didn't like the format. I didn't like the way that you go to the towns. It wasn't like normal Warband at all. It was just kind of weird. It does look cool, but when I played it, I was really kind of really let down because I was really looking forward to like a Caribbean Warband pirates fighting Warband swords, everything. And somebody could take the Warband engine and make a badass pirate mod with that. If I had the skills for doing meshes, I could do it myself. But a pirate Warband game would be just badass. This music's too loud, I gotta turn it off. See, with this Twitch, I love this because that music, I was just running that in the background as an invisible, it was actually an invisible square sitting right here, and the invisible square was playing music in the background right where my finger's at. That's what I like about this Twitch app. It's so easy to use. Houses Monsters. Man, there's some cool looking games out there that I'd love to play. Like, you play two of the games that I wanted to play that I haven't played yet. Exiles and Kingdom Come. I've got the Battle of the Bulge, December, between December 15th and December 20th, last 2 weeks of 1944. Was super hot, crazy battles in the wintertime between the American GIs, Canadians, British, against the Germans that attacked. Battle of Bastogne, Battle of the Bulge, Eppledorf, St. Vith, in winter with tanks and Shermans, and the Germans rolled in with Tiger IIs, kicking ass, Battle of the Bulge. And so I have like four maps lined up in chronological order, starting at December 16th, going all the way through December 20th. Eppledorf, Meuse River, which was General Patton's third fighting at Meuse River, I believe. St. Vith, and then the Bastogne, the Battle of Bastogne, nuts. And so that's four maps. I don't know if I can stay awake for all four of them, because each map is about 1,000. Soldiers on 1,000, but I'm only playing one round per map. I'm going to try to do four maps. I wish I could chat. That's the whole purpose. That's the whole point of getting on a network like Twitch or YouTube or Facebook and streaming games. It's chat and stream with people. And if I can do a good deed and help people out who have cancer or multiple sclerosis or handicapped kids, prost. So this beer fest right here, Gettysburg Brew Fest. This glass, the last time I went there for the Gettysburg Brew Fest, we were doing artillery. I'm a member of the first Pennsylvania Light Artillery Battery D, and we're Yankee artillery. I'm a powder monkey. And so we're shooting cannons at this Brew Fest, and we also are the cannon crew that shoots the cannon at the Battle of Pickett's Charge on July 3rd here where I live in the Gettysburg Battlefield. I'm a fucking nutcase. I shoot cannons for a hobby. No shit. In real life, at Pickett's Charge, I live on a battlefield. Everyone hates me and everyone loves me. I'm someone's dad. I have an adult daughter. My daughter's 23 and she's kick-ass. She's like 6 foot tall Valkyrie with colored hair and shit. She does cosplay. Yeah, man, I love shooting cannons. I did infantry for a long time, for years. My buddy who pops in here, Irish Reb, my moderator, he's one of my reenactor buddies. He's in the Irish Brigade, like the real Irish Brigade. Thousands of reenactors here where I live. So here where I live, I can take my musket and my bayonet and I can dress out in Civil War gear. People here, my friends, we walk right down the road, right downtown, with rifles and muskets. That's normal. And so you see a lot of people here downtown in different time periods. There's carriages and horses downtown where I live. There's Amish buggies that go past my house. So it's very different. And I'm not originally from here. I grew up right outside of Chicago in a very small town called, an area called Norway in LaSalle County. And it's where the very first Scandinavians settled here in America, in the United States, I should say, because you're an American too. And our Mexican brothers, they're Americans too. And I'm running at the mouth, dude, and I want to jump into some winter, because for the past several games that I was playing Forgotten Hope 2, I was in the desert. And the desert's okay, but I like the variety. And then, in a couple of days, I'll probably jump into the jungle and do the, I think it's the 5th Marines, and they do the entire island chain battles of Tarawa, Tulagi, I think, the Philippines. I think my brother's in the Philippines right now with his wife, and they go up in the mountains and stuff in these shacks and amazing gardens on these mountainsides. It's a trip. But I'm gonna jump in, dude. And if you bail and I don't catch you, and you bail, dude, thanks for tuning in. Sleep well. But when you do, if I miss you, sleep well, my friend, and you have an awesome day tomorrow. I'm going to be doing some live streaming artwork, some illustrations. I do a lot of fantasy stuff like Dungeons and Dragons. And so I'm going to do some of that hopefully this weekend. Start doing that on the weekends. I went to the finest art school in the world. I was accepted there when I was 14, so I was told I'm a pretty good artist. But I decided in a career in cukes and tomatoes. But my crash, and I'll just reboot it in like 2 seconds, but my game's ready to roll. Looks like I'm having some FPS weirdness, like you can see my screen. Up at the top, I'm looking at my FPS and it's going yellow at me on my FPS. But we're in 15 minutes, and when I move, when I move, I will be able to afford a better computer, because I need to buy a computer that's going to be the last computer that I own. The next place I move to has to be the last place I move to, because I've got about 10 years to go if I'm lucky. So I should live it up as best I can. Looking at the ocean with my dogs and a fishing pole and playing some kick-ass video games with a decent computer. So let's get back in our game, and we should be all ready to go. Eppledorf, December 16th, 1944. Check it out. Badass. So we've got the Volksgrenadiers of the 267th Division have captured the town of Eppledorf. Swift counterattacked by American forces, so that'd be Canadians and Americans, probably British as well. Germans gearing up for another offensive push, so Eppledorf, and then Meuse River with Patton. Patton's up there. So Patton's roaming around somewhere. Same day, December 16th, 1944, the Germans launched an offensive named Operation Wacht am Rhein. Its goal was to split the Western Allies on the Ardennes region. This time under a thick winter fog as protection against the ever-looming threat of Allied air power, the Battle of the Bulge has begun. And so these maps are all Battle of the Bulge 44, 1944 in December. St. Vith and their push towards the ultimate objective of Antwerp. The 5th Panzer Army had to cross a vital road junction of St. Vith. The town represented the right flank in the German advance and was close to the boundary between the 5th and 6th Panzer Army. The U.S. 7th Armored Division, which had taken the town of Vith as a key strategic stronghold. A year ago, I had no problems talking. So we have to slow down that panzer assault. So the Germans are on the move. In every one of these four maps, the Germans are on the move. December 16th, so December 20th, to wrap it up, is Bastogne. And so let's start with Eppledorf. Make sure we're in co-op mode, right on, 10 second spawn time, one player, that's me, ticket ratio. We don't have control over the ticket ratio because these are Forgotten Hope and CMP community multiplayer maps made for single player co-op. So you have to play them in single player co-op. A lot of people ask me, how do I play these maps? Create a local server, go to co-op, download the CMP community maps and updater, run the updater, play your CMP multiplayer co-op maps, and just set your max players, play it, create local co-op server, and that's how you play these maps. And that's how you play these excellent Finnish maps that everyone's asked me about. Tali co-op, Samadas. So my friends, let's get into Eppledorf, and this is gonna be bitchin'. and I wish I had on-screen chat. I cannot put this game in windowed mode because it completely messes up the HUD. The menu clicks are off. The hitboxes are off. 3 miles from the German defensive line lay the small village of Eppeldorf. After an intense artillery barrage, the Volksgrenadiers of the 276th Division, Jawohl, had captured the town. But a swift counterattack by American forces pushed them back to the easterly outskirts. Now, with the Germans gearing up for another offensive push, and despite the already snowy conditions, both sides prepare for battle. So wish us luck. So I'm going to do this by maps. We got 4 maps, so it's going to be best 3 out of 4. If it's 2 out of 2 maps and it's a tie, we'll run a tiebreaker, which will be the next map in chronological order after the Battle of Bastogne. And I'll try to remember that 3 hours from now, which isn't likely. The downside is I have multiple sclerosis and I can't remember stuff. The upside is I have everybody's phone numbers in my phone, and I am a master merry prankster. You know, I'm sitting here wondering, I got all these ideas, build a business up again, you know, what about like a topless, what about a topless taco delivery service or a topless pizza delivery service? They gotta have that in Las Vegas. They got to. That's just the kind of service that disabled, isolated people need. I'm telling you, man. Yeah, I want a topless Subway sandwich. Rock and roll. This is a conquest head-on map. Your team will win if you cause your opponent's tickets to reach 0 as usual. Right on. Welcome to the amazing 3-time or more Mod of the Year winner, Forgotten Hope 2. And I've been playing this puppy for, 15 years? Awesome. So we're going to go straight up assault. Fire team, dog, hot diggity ding dang dog. And let's pick an interesting fire team. So let's get a Rosa, bye bye, bye bye, bye bye, bye bye. We'll keep Zaphod Beeblebrox. We'll take the Jerky Boys. Who else did I put in here? Come on, give me somebody interesting. Let's take Shitbox. We'll take Shitbox. I love Shitbox, he's my favorite. Who else do? We don't have Bilbo. We got Willy Wonka. We'll take Willy Wonka. Cool. I'm lagging a little bit. I can feel it. I don't think we could take any. Let's take some grass. I see 2 shitboxes. I see 2 Wonkas. How many we got? Yeah, I'm lagging a little bit. I might have to reboot this. Yeah, I got my 6 guys. Me, the infamous Daryl, the incredible Mr. Nobody, the Jerky Boys, Zaphod Beeblebrox, grass. You can't beat grass, especially if you have MS. Shitbox McGillicuddy and Willy Wonka. Right on. So, let's start in the rear with the gear and grab some vehicles. All right, rock and roll. My tank, bitch. Yeah. Get in, hosers. Get in, hosers.
Jump in.
There's a path right up there. Whoa! Hey, I had a feeling that was gonna go shit on me. So I'll jump right back in. Day, that was fun. I love it. It's like I felt like I got hit by like a V2 rocket or something. Boom. So I'm going back in. I'll be right back in. Doggone. Diggity dang. You know what I think was causing that? I don't want to turn those down anymore. I'll turn that anti-aliasing off. Boom. Ouch. That hurt. Come on, give us some joy. Good, good, good. That's it, right on. So we're back. Let's try to get this to work this time without crashing. Ah, rock and roll. It might be the lighting crashing that, I'm not sure. Hope I don't have to get out and check my NVIDIA card. It'll only take me a minute. When I walk, it feels like there's piranha eating my legs. And it's just my brain playing tricks on my legs. Come on, optimizers. Some days like today, I just feel like getting in tanks and just shooting at stuff. And I love Forgotten Hope too. The original Forgotten Hope was excellent, man. The multiplayer community was great. I was in a tanker group and everything. My online name was Karius. I think we were the Ghost Squadron. It was kick-ass. We did a lot of early war, early Panzers. It was really fun. So let's not crash, man. Crashed about 3 times on me the other night. Something's up. It's bugging the shit out of me. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. that shit? Bastard. There's a tiger sitting right there too. This is gonna be good. This is gonna be really good. Rock and roll. Condor, baby. Condor. Jagdpanzer, right there on my left at my 9 o'clock. I didn't even see him. He's all low profile and shit. Yeah, they're kicking our ass. We've got more men, but we're not going to hold it. As soon as they take some weight and some flags, we're done. They're kicking our ass. My next death, I can try to flank him on the left flank. Where's all their armor? I thought they were attacking. Where's the 21st Panzer Division? Let's go, let's go, let's go. How do I delete that command?
Defend our position.
There we go. M36. See if we can flank them. What the hell is taking me out in one shot? That's happened like three times. What? Nebelwerfer. Let's take that freaking Nebelwerfer out. Shit. He's taking me out three times. One shot, Nebelwerfer. Now I got no ride. So we go get a ride. Come on, tank, come on, tank. Spawn, spawn, spawn. We're staying off that road. We have to flank that. We gotta flank that number worker. Come on, rotate. Yeah, baby. shoots first lives longest. Old German proverb. Now where's that Nebelwerfer at? Where's he shooting those rockets from? Like that. Die, bitch. Fucker killed me 3 times. He killed me. Payback. He blasted me 3 times. One hit, you're gone, boy. Gone. Angel's stupid sandbags. Germans aren't really coming in force, we're kicking their ass. They're just not really coming in force at all. don't stand a chance. Diggity, diggity damn. Here we go again. Rock and roll, much better. I have the Ayatollah of Rock and Roller's footrest. Excellent. Given to me by Yul Brynner himself. It's a Springfield, I'll stick with my Enfield. And I'm still back in the same mangy hole. That's right, fire that cannon, boy. That's right, fire it. Go on, Jerky. Give him a sizzle chest, that's right. Where's my damn tank, you assholes? Shit, looks like I'm running again. Let's switch spots. Engineer, please. Thank you. Looks like we're freaking trucking again. I always wanted to see what that would look like. Those are like freaking atomic bombs. They're almost done, these shits. I think I got an engineer kit. I want a sniper rifle. Nada. What's up, honkies? Oh man, Super Freak Show's in the house. Holy shit, taking a nap. It fights this way. Let's go, let's go, let's go. What's up, honkies?
Follow me! Cover me!
Where's the Germans? kind of sucked. It wasn't that exciting or entertaining. It was kind of not much of a German onslaught, but they were like one shot, one kill. That sucked. 84 points. Not so good. I'll hop out here in a second. And so, it should be showing us the next map information. It shouldn't be the same map. Wow, wow, wow. Nah, I don't believe it. That was horrible. Terrible. Terrible. Terrible, Daryl. So we're going to Muse River. I'm going to hop out for a second, though. Jump back into Twitch. Say hey. Right on. So what's up next December 16th, the very same day the Germans launched offensive Operation Wacht am Rhein. Its goal was to split the Western Allies' line in the Ardennes. Snow on the ground. Excellent. So, cool, cool beans. If I get back in here. All right. What's up, you little freaks? That map kind of sucked. That wasn't like the most exciting killer battle. Oh, right on, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Awesome, awesome. What's up, Cody? Are you still here? Creeping, you mean you're moderating with your big white sword. Yeah, so sometime... You want me to stream Viking Conquest on Wednesdays or Thursdays or something, man, just let me know. You know, if you're around during the day and you wanted me to stream some Viking Conquest, it's just, right on. But, it's a little choppy. I wish my streams were like they were, when I started on Twitch. I have another video card I'm going to throw in. It's the same video card, but it's made by a different company. And I didn't even know I had it, but I did. So I'm going to see if that'll make a difference. But I'm playing Battle of the Bulge. It's all Battle of the Bulge. And so we just fought Eppeldorf, and I thought it wasn't the most exciting time I played that map. I played that map 100 times. The Germans really didn't. They weren't very aggressive. But then we got Meuse River with Patton, and then St. Vith, and then wrap it up with... Not if you're not a PC user. I mean, if you're a PC gamer like I am, well, video cards are integral. I probably got six of them laying around here. But yeah, using a PC and playing a game, you need to have a third-party video card. And my next rig, the video card that I will get, will probably run me half the cost of the computer. I was wondering, man, if you're on PlayStation, Cody, you should, whatever console you're using, why don't you stream your games to Twitch? I would watch your games, especially if you're playing Assassin's Creed. You should be streaming that Assassin's Creed to your Twitch channel, dude. I'd watch that. I totally. Holy shit. You guys lost me. Prost. Chindanya. Skull. Cheers. Gettysburg Brewfest. Man. Hot summertime, bikinis, brews, and cannons. Oh, dude. The next time you come visit, bring your computer with you. Bring your computer with you. If you want any of the games that I play on your computer so that we can play them co-op streaming multiplayer online, bring your computer with you the next time you come visit. Man, I'll tell you what, it sure is nice to drink a beer. It was so nice of Uncle Sam to give us a little bit of our money back after working for 30 years. You know, we had a tea party about this very same thing back in 1776 in Boston. Yep, you guys are still there. Well, I'll watch you play it. Because I would just have to sit there and learn it. It'd be boring. And so I'd watch you play it because you already know how to play it. But streaming it, that's the shit right there, because I'd like to watch that. I'd like to watch my friends play games. Then, you know, I meet people, but if my friends are out playing, I like to watch my friends play because it's fun. I think our next map in Battle of the Bulge, December 1944, Battle of the Bulge, Eppledorf, Meuse River, St. Vith, Battle of Bastogne. Nuts. Remember? Nuts. Yeah, just like I said, I just need to know what your PC is, what your PC specs are, see what you can play. But like my computer, I need twice the computer that I have to really do what I want with it. To stream what I want, the games that I want to stream, the mods that I want to stream, and streaming it good quality, I need twice the computer that I have. And so once I move, I can easily do that. My retirement pirate bungalow, as the governor of wherever land, Villa Kula, will be affordable enough where I can have the little luxuries I'd like to have in life when I want them, like Belgian waffles. I love Belgian waffles. I love Kringlas and lingonberries. But I love me some Forgotten Hope. I was just on the servers and I didn't see anybody playing on the servers, but I know there's competitions over the weekends for Forgotten Hope 2. And I mean major competitions, like historical scenarios. And I've been invited by the mod developers because I showcase their mod all the time. And I love their mod. I've been playing their mod, shit, man, for years. I love Forgotten Hope 2. But you guys, I'm going to jump back in the game, dudes, and I think we're at Meuse River with Patton. So I hope this doesn't crash. If it crashes, I'll just fire the map back up again. I think I might have a conflict in my graphics card with lighting. I'm not sure. I'll have to see. Yep, everything looks good. I just had to double check. Right on. F- 4 years later in 1944, the Panzers are once again rolling over the bridges on the Meuse River, this time under a thick winter fog as protection against the ever-looming threat of Allied air power looms. The Battle of the Bulge has begun. The Battle of the Bulge, baby. So I wonder what units we're playing exactly. Oh yeah, this is going to be a bloodbath. So I'll take some explosives. We'll be dogs again. Give me some armor if you got it. Oh yeah, this is fucking fun. This map is bitching. Oh yeah. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, 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 bitch. Get back with my tank. Oh yeah. You got my name on you, don't you, right there? Yeah, I'll take you.
Let's go, let's go, let's go!
Lad. damn it. Man, that's getting old. It really is. That's the second time it's crashed. That ticks me off. There's something up with my settings. I don't know what it is. So, give me a minute. Something's crashing me. And it could be my antivirus. It's not. Huh. Man, that's a bummer. I can't even complete that map. So, that blows. So we carry on. I don't know what could be doing that. Trying this one again. Load up some Counter-Strike. need it. What did I miss? Yeah. They'll demand, yeah, right on. Hey, Falco, thanks for the follow. Thanks for tuning in. Echo, echo. Oh, right on. Hey, thanks. There's an echo in my game. Yeah, no worries. Yeah, I hope it's not choppy. In any event, you guys, thanks for tuning in and thanks for the follow. Right on. The pilot's got a boner for me. I'm telling you, what's up with that? Shoot that damn plane down. Rock and roll. Doc might pay for that shit. Where are you going, Sonny? Move your ass. Baby, turn. Stukas, man, they got like a picture of me and they throw darts at it in their aerodrome. Freaking Stuka pilots hate me. See that shit? Sherman. Sure, is right. Guys are still hung over. Diggity ding dang dog. Thank you. Well, I know where their hideout is. The Red Skull and the Agents of Hydra. Versus Captain America and his jolly band of drunken fornicators. You guys ever want to quit smoking? Try cigars. It worked for me. I haven't smoked a cigarette since. Well, looks like it's me in the Jeep again. Stupid soldiers. Crazy monkeys with helmets and guns, I'm telling you. Alright, the Jerky Boys got 12th. Tommy Chong got 11th. Shitbox got 9th. Conan got 7th. Conan kicks ass. Everyone loves Conan. So that was Muse River. And it's always like a bottleneck right there at that bridge. Whoop-dee-doo, Daryl. Most played kit engineer, usually. Put some mines in the ground. Armor. Most deaths. Accuracy? Me? Really? I'm blind as a bat. I didn't do any engineering. Huh. Top scores, rock and roll. And if you guys are still tuning in, thanks for tuning in. And if you guys bail, you guys sleep well, dream awesome dreams, and have a badass day tomorrow. So Battle of the Bulge began on December 16th, 1944, and that's the maps we're playing tonight. Those damn Jagdpanzers, man, shit. I love driving them. I played German for years. That's why I've been playing GI a lot last year and this year. I like playing more interesting units. New Zealanders, Australians, Canadians. They don't get enough. They don't get enough exposure. And their push towards the ultimate objective of Antwerp, the German 5th Panzer Army had to cross the vital road junctions of St. Vith. The town represented the right flank and the German advance was close to the boundary from the 5th and 6th Panzer Army. There to slow down the German advance was the U.S. 7th Armored. which had taken the town of St. Vith as a key strategic stronghold. Kick ass, but I'm going to hop out and chill for a minute. Oh yeah, this is cool. With the railroad, I remember that. Bitchin'. Cool beans. I wish I had a, I need to look into settings. I need to look into some widgets and applets so I can get timestamps on people's chats. No, I wasn't Falco. I wasn't playing at multiplayer. I used to be in a squad. I used to be in a clan. But no, I'm not playing. It's a crusty game. Yeah, it is. It is a crusty game. That's a pretty good... I like that. It's a crusty game. It is. That's funny. Falco, the commissar's in town. Yep, the commissar's in town, Falco. There we go. GI Radio. Man, that oatmeal stout was good. Sammy Smith's Tadcaster. Man, if you only ever have a couple of beers a year, and I only have a couple of beers a year, that's the bomb. Rock and roll. Crusty game. Chunk all your junk back in the trunk. Fall on your bunk. Yeah. Let's finish this fight. So where are we at? Engineer. That's too bad. No engineer. That five shot clip would be nice. Recon with a mine doesn't do me any good. I'll pick one up off the ground. So what are we looking at? Ah, shit. Engineer.
Defend our position. Defend our position. Got my number too. Holy shit. Holy shit, Sergeant. Man, there's no fancy rides. Where's the fancy rides? Thank you. 9, 9, 9, 9. Pleasure, General. General Patton. Let's go, boys.
Follow me!
Good man, good man. Potato masher. Yep. Steel hand grenade 43. Yep, no fancy rides. Get that flag, boys, get that flag. Let me down. What the hell, man? You guys got me up here in the hotel suite. What's up? In the penthouse.
Defend
holy hell. Okay, so we got trucks. Looks like that's it. Trucks. That's it. We got a couple of trucks. Oh, give me a break. Now I'm not going to be able to go through this crap somehow. Oh shit, come on, don't tell me I just did that. I did, didn't I? I did.
Bug out! Follow me!
Stupid, stupid Daryl. Alrighty then, Sergeant. No sniper rifle, just a bazooka. just as I was telling them to get out, out, out.
Roger that!
I didn't even see him there. Well, we're holding him, I think. Yeah, we're holding him pretty good. I'm thinking first one to get to 1,000 troops loses. This is, there's too many troops in this map. There's over 1,000, that's too many.
Follow me!
fucker. Be a lower caliber, or it's just not as accurate. I hit him, he didn't go down. That's three times I hit him, he didn't go down. They got 37 left to go, and I'm going to call it a match. See that shit? Yeah, he's blasting off a bazooka. Damn! I've lost sound on my hearing aid, so I'm gonna call it a match. I might load up another map. I'm gonna take 5. Cool beans. And I'm gonna get a drink. I'm probably gonna load up another map. I'm gonna fire up one more map. Let's hope we don't crash this crusty old game. So we'll see what we can do. Pardon me. Alrighty. Something totally different. We were going to do Bastogne, and so we should do Bastogne. That's a tangle, isn't it? It sure is. And we were just playing St. Vith. There was way too many people. There was way too many bots in that. There was like 2,000 troops. And so I figure we warmed down 600, so we won. We still had 500 troops. They were down 600. So we had St. Vith and then we had Bastogne. But I thought I would do something a little different, like Bardia. I think it was Bardia. And we will finish off Bastogne just like I had planned. I'm not gonna change my plans at this point. One last map, and hopefully it's not huge. So let's do Bastogne to finish off our run of four maps of the Battle of the Bulge, December 1944. And so we started out with Eppeldorf, December 16th, and then Meuse River, December 16th. And then St. Vith, also between the 16th and the 20th, and now we're fighting Bastogne on December 20th to finish off this run of these four maps. So December 20th, 1944, the German offensive December 16th, had been a complete surprise to the Allies. As the inexperienced Allied divisions on the front line were destroyed by the German onslaught, the 101st U.S. Airborne Division was hastily called in to plug the gap. By the morning of December 19th, the division had arrived in Bastogne. The next day, it was completely surrounded, cut off from the Allied supply lines. Without any possibility of being supplied by air due to the harsh winter weather, and even without proper winter gear, the 101st had to hold out against an enemy who had been preparing their offensive for months. My memory is not as good as it used to be because of MS, but I believe Bastogne was surrounded. The German commander had offered the Allied commander the opportunity to surrender, and his reply to the German commander was, "Nuts." And that's it. Nuts. See if we can grab some armor. We're going to be all the way in the rear. It looks like there might be some armor right there. Jeeves and crap. I don't know. That's German. That's German. It's American.
Attack the enemy position!
Yeah, baby. I just had to see the Bastogne sign. I just had to. Stop swinging. That tank just does not want to live. Grenades or something. Thank you. GIs in that half track. There's GIs in that half track. That's got to be a German in that Jagdpanzer if it's not destroyed. It's destroyed. That was nuts. That was nuts. That was insane. That was like Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. The gnome mobile. That was nuts. What is this vehicle? I hear a vehicle. They seem to get stuck over here. Shit. I don't know who that is. I don't think it's one of mine. Did the trick. Looks like I got some walking to do. Truck's not operational, there's no vehicles, looks like I'm freaking walking. It's showing vehicles, I can't drive those though, I don't think. You hear that? Shit. Freaking German planes, man. German planes are dangerous.
Charge! Roger that!
cover me!
the hell? I jump up on these all the time. Stupid. Right on. Thanks for tuning in. I'm calling it a night. Awesome, man. Have an awesome day. Sleep well. It's past my bedtime. Have a good one, dude. Thanks for tuning in. Have a good one, bro.